The legend lives on from the Chippewa down of the big lake they call Kitchikumi. The lake, it is said, never gives up for dead when the skies of November turn gloomy. A load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty. The good shipping crew was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early. As big freighters go, it was bigger than most, with a crew and a captain well seasoned, including some terms with a couple steel firms when they left fully loaded for Cleveland. And later that night, when the ship's bell rang, could it be the north wind they've been feeling?
They might have split up, or they
quite a capsize. They may have broke deep and took water, and all that remains are the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters. We'll be right back.
Here. Thank you.